Hello and welcome back to the Roohaa Degozaru no video blog. Hey yo, so do desu ka? Do desu ka? Tell you how it is. It's cold. I'm wearing my scarf and stuff because I just got back from honorable shopping. And today, since I got this fancy new camera, I want to try and check out the time-lapse feature on it, because time-lapse is cool, I think. And I'm going to show you how I make mashed potatoes, because I have a potluck party tonight. It's the year-end Christmas party at Honorable Art School Degozaru, and everyone always asks me about the recipe, and, you know, I don't really measure anything because measuring is for losers. And I'm going to show a video of me doing it, and they're going to probably be counting the potatoes, you know, and the amount of garlic I put in. But I'm going to do time lapse while I'm peeling potatoes and stuff and while I'm chopping garlic, because I think it'll be kind of cool. All right. So, yeah, this is the intro, not in time lapse. I don't know if volume happens in time-lapse or not, but I'm going to figure it out. Otherwise, I'll just put some music on top of it, and YouTube will kick me off the internet as usual. All right, well, here's to making potatoes. You know what? Yeah, I'll wait for later for that. All right, so what you need to make mashed potatoes is very simple. You need a pot, preferably a big pot, unless you're just going to make a couple potatoes. You're gonna need gas or some kind of accelerant, which leads to something which creates flame. Ideally, you'll need a cutting board, cute frog preferred, and you need a blade to cut your tates. You'll need a peeler of some sort, and eventually, when push comes to shove, you're gonna need a masher. If you have a mixer, that'd be nice. This is dusty, I gotta wash it. But if you have a masher, that's clutch. Mashing by hand is best because I love creamy potatoes, but too creamy and just don't feel right. I like chunks. You're going to need potatoes. I got a lot of potatoes here. Garlic. Garlic is key. When Roohaa makes potatoes, Roohaa garlics them up. A lot of potatoes. This is heresy. That's just for bread. I bought that because I want that because it's margarine. I got cooking salt. You're not going to need that much. You're going to need some milk. It says milk. Trust me. I think it says milk. Yeah. Right? I think I bought milk. Yeah, it's milk. It's milk. Don't worry. An honorable butter. This looks like Hokkaido butter. Butter from the Great Wide North. That's all. After that, I gotta peel my potatoes, then chop up the garlic while the potatoes are boiling, and then I usually put the milk and one thing of butter in with the garlic, and then mix it up nice. And then when the time comes, you put them together, you mash them. Get ready. We're gonna do it together. All right. So it's gonna be set up like this. First thing I like to do is I like to get my water going as soon as I can. So you can see right here, I'm just filling up my pot with water. I'm not gonna fill it up all the way because the potatoes are gonna take up a lot of space, but yeah, halfway is fine. And I'm just gonna throw it on low heat just to get it ready. Nice. Nothing crazy. This way, as I'm cutting the potatoes and washing them, the water will be ready so I don't have to, like, wait for it to boil forever. So, next I'm going to do the next shot in time lapse. I'm going to give the potatoes a rough wash, then I'm going to peel them. Get ready. Here we go.
Thank you.
Okay. Welcome back. I hope the time lapse worked out. I'm not going to check it until probably weeks from now because I'm just going to make potatoes. It's currently 1:16 according to the clock on my wall. My potatoes are in the water. There they are. I'm going to turn the heat up on them now that they're ready to cook. Whoops, not down, up. So they'll warm up. I did some dishes right at the end there, because I find it's, if you do dishes while you're cooking, then you never have dishes to do. Except then I leave the bowls that I ate out of till the next time I cook, which is what I did. Next is garlic. Garlic is gonna happen. So I'm gonna do another time-lapse video of me chopping garlic and then perhaps putting it in a pot. I'll use my honorable breakfast. Still got the goodness from this morning's breakfast. Maybe people aren't into that, but I'm currently seasoning my Teflon pan. I'm serious. All right, so I'm talking to a camera and make potatoes. Party, I gotta catch train at 3:30, so I got 2.5 hours. 2:30, 3:30. I got about 2 hours, 2.5 hours. So, enjoy watching me cut garlic, which is the next phase. Personally, I'm gonna cut in 2 cloves, see what it looks like, or two heads of garlic and see where I'm at, but maybe I won't need that much. We'll see, it's a matter of preference, really. But I think I'm gonna go for 2. And then begin the garlic browning process. So I like to brown my garlic and create like a garlic batter before I throw it in there. So here we go. Well, I just finished peeling and cutting all that garlic, which you can see right here. And my potatoes are boiling. I don't know if you saw the steamy knife action. I just gave it a quick stir. Here, I'll use a chopstick. Let's see. Can't do it with a chopstick. I need a fork. Oh yeah, I think they're ready. Yep, they're ready. So, I'm gonna turn the heat off on these bad boys. Let them chill for a second. Then, I'm gonna get the garlic ready. That's what I'm gonna do right now. So pretty much from now on, I don't need to really do time lapse. So I'm just gonna shoot a video of me doing the garlic and the potatoes. So here we go. All right, so now I'm gonna put this stuff over here, put it in the sink. You can see the pot, right? Okay. So first things first, hit it with a little oil. Turn the heat on again. And then I'm gonna take all that garlic I chopped up, just put it right in. Ideally, you wanna do this on a lower heat. I'm a real big fan of cooking everything on low heat. I like that soft tenderness. But when it comes to garlic, you can't really fool around, or else you're gonna burn it. And if you burn your garlic, I mean, it's not really a big deal, but you don't wanna burn your garlic. So I'm gonna wait for this. Here, I just got some. Just so I look cool, I'll use my cooking chopsticks. So I'm just spreading them out nice and wide. What I want is, I want them brown. I wanna get the flavors moving. You know, raw garlic's good and it's strong, but it's not what looking for. So it's on really low heat. Really low heat. Spread it out real nice. All actually, chopsticks aren't going to be good. I just realized that. Alright, and what I do, so that it's not just garlic, is... Oh man, that smells intense. I love garlic. Seriously do. You wonder why I love garlic mashed potatoes? It's because I love garlic. Japanese people are like, wow, that's a lot of garlic! I know. It's alright, you don't gotta eat them. I'll eat everything. And I recently tested myself, didn't mean to test myself, but I made way too many mashed potatoes on Thanksgiving. And I took them all home. Nobody really got any, I guess they didn't want them. But, oh man, I ate mashed potatoes literally for a week. Felt good. I am so alone, gonna find a big old brother bones. So pretty much what I'm doing right now is just all flavor. If you want, you can put other stuff. Sometimes I put corn soup. They have this kick-ass corn pottage here in Japan. It's kind of sweet. And instead of putting like a lot of milk or cream, I'll just put corn pottage in, and it gives it a whole different flavor, you know? Garlicky corn goodness. That's what I like. But... Alright, I'm gonna give it a couple more seconds. And this time, I'm going to drain the tates. They need a little time to rest out of this hot water. I feel so alone, gonna grind a big old pile of dirt bones. Can't all. I can't. Whatever. Yeah. Oh my God, why am I doing that to myself? Whatever. All right, so. Potatoes are there, they're steaming, they're ready. Just gotta get most of that liquid out. I didn't get it all out. Then again, I don't really care about a lot of things. You just stay there. Back over to my... There we go. Alright, so... I kind of blackened them on one side. Actually, that's okay. So what we do now is throw in a little milk. So now what I do, see the heat's way too hot. You want the milk in there, because I feel like the milk kind of forms a friendly bond with the garlic, and they become a strong agent of flavor together. Together. And I don't know if you hear it, but I'm preparing the butter. Sticks of butter in Japan come pre-chopped into pieces, which is convenient. Some sticks of butter, not all of them. So you see, look, just opened a fresh boy. It's already cut. So I don't need to struggle to cut through a cold thing of butter. But, you see me over here? basically right here. Just gonna take one stick, one little pat of butter, just plop it in. Butter will make the milk and everything work together real nice. Let's watch it melt together. Oh yeah, baby. River! Oh man, you know, if you can hear the Alice in Chains in the background, I'm probably gonna have to make this a non-monetized video. Whatever. And I don't give a damn. Alright, butter is effectively melted. So now, while this is doing that, I'm mashing. So let me wash my masher. I showed it to the internet that it was dirty. I mash potatoes all the time, you know. Usually only special occasions, because mashed potatoes are special. Alright, so my garlic is fooling around. Garlic buttermilk. Smells good, that much I can tell you. But basically, I just want this to get a little thicker. So first thing I do when mashing is, I mean, it's not like you're gonna be able to see it. But you can kind of see it. What's in the way? Oh, the pot. That's the actual pot. Just push down. Smash them. Smash taters. First thing is you just mash them. Phase one, they're dry. They're gonna look real dry. Not like mashed potatoes you wanna eat particularly, because you can tell the second you put them in your mouth, it's gonna be like desert city. I just wanna get rid of that shape. Then milk. Milk is key. I don't measure. I just pour a bunch in. But you don't want to pour too much in. I just poured in maybe a quarter of the milk thingy. Quarter of a quart. What's that? Half a pint. So now the potatoes are starting to look smoother and creamier, which is key. And the potatoes on the bottom I couldn't get to before, now feeling the pain. I guess I should get footage of this. Oh, hold. So you can see the potatoes, they're real fluffy, or kind of fluffy right now. Let's see where we're at. Good, little creamy, very little flavor if any. That's where that's going to come in. So after you put a little milk in, now it's time to put some butter in there. So I'm gonna put this camera in my mouth. I know this is gonna be regretful. Actually, not so bad. Alright, cool. Tripod on my chest to stabilize. And I got the strap in my mouth. You're gonna have to forgive my accent from here on out. It's chest cam, baby. But I need two hands to do this, and
Whatever. Deal with it. Alright, bring over bring over the butter. And first, let's put in, how about 4?
Alright, so now I got hand free. Yep, so let's put them in, let them melt a little. I mean, all the butter's going in, so who am I kidding? I'm gonna throw a couple more in. And at this point, you gotta be really careful about your garlic, your mixture, because it's gonna wanna mess up. See, that's the key of having it on ultra-low heat, is that even if it starts fooling around, little garlic shenanigans, you know, you don't mess anything up. That's another reason why I like to cook it in milk and butter and not just the garlic, because I don't know. Garlic's like tissue paper or something when you're cooking it. You know, it's good, and then poof, it's ruined. Maybe tissue paper is a terrible analogy, but whatever. Deal with it again. Seriously, not a cooking show host, but I do enjoy cooking. So this butter is starting to get good. Melt. Melt, damn you. You'll notice the milk is still out because the milk's still going to get used. I'm running low on battery. I'm scared. We'll be right. Alright, back to mouth cam. Getting there. Alright. And since I'm ready for it, I'm getting it. Alright, I'm gonna need 2 hands and no camera in my mouth for this one, so putting you back down, Lenny. Hope it looks good from over there. Oh, yeah, baby. Get it all out now. This deserves a rinse. Soap too. Put a few garlic pieces, you know you gotta get a little time to love. And you know what else? I'm gonna put a little bit more milk in. I like them real creamy. As does everybody else. So, as does many other people, I should say. I actually prefer my mashed potatoes with skin on. But people don't like that. Here we go. So you can see my goodness in there. Okay. The camera. I'm not even looking. All right. So, final phase. They taste good. They need salt. So the key with mashed potatoes is do not undersalt them. In this form, they're edible. They have a little garlic kick. But if I throw a little salt in there, and pepper, because I prefer, salt makes the potatoes perfect. So I'm going to throw in the last three pads of butter. And I'm going to salt the crap out of them. Assault them, if you will. It was really funny. I hope you're laughing at home. Can't stop laughing. No. So, potatoes. Alright, so this is not gonna be enough salt, but don't be afraid to salt them up real good. I got a lot of potatoes in here. I'm just gonna use the rest of that. It wasn't a lot. Down in a hole. Alright, maybe that's a lot of salt. That's right, if you mix them good, it doesn't matter. Nice. I rolled the dice and I got really close. Oh, I almost put too much salt in. It's like I said, I didn't need that much. And just a little pepper, a couple cracks. I think it gives it a nice color. I like having the black amidst all the white in the potato party. It was not a racist comment. But, and the pepper gives it a little spice, you know. At this point, if you had an electric mixer, I'd say throw in a little bit more milk, and you can get them really, really creamy. Nice. All right, those are my potatoes. I made them. So this is what. Well, hold on. I like to do it a little. So to me, mashed potatoes are the same exact thing as cookie batter. This is how I prepare. All right, well, perfect timing. My camera's batteries are running out. So that's how you make Roohaa mashed potatoes. That's good. Oh, that's good. So, as long as my camera's batteries keep going, you can just watch me do this. This is gross, right? Too much water, you sure? I can't believe I'm filming this part. I do it every time, though. Potato mashes are especially fun because they got all these little nooks and crannies. And I have plenty of time left. I have an hour and a half to get to the train station. I'll probably reheat the potatoes one more time once I get to the party. It's usually what I do every year. But, yeah. All right, I need to get a chopstick. Don't think you're off the hook. You're gonna watch me eat the whole thing. Hope you can see. Monkeys using tools. No! I think I'm just gonna let potato go to waste. I'm not some kind of savage beast. Since I really don't care about what I put on the internet, really, I'll probably just put this whole part in its entirety on there. Why don't you make a GIF of it and send it to me? Really embarrassing one. It's on my face. I know it's on my face. Just get over it. Ah, oh, dude, it's like one of my favorite songs. I karaoke the shit out of this song.